Hello dear friends, welcome to the world of mathematics. It's me Srija Suresh and you are watching SS Math Solutions. In this video, I am going to share how to find the inverse of a matrix by using elementary operation. Let's go how to find the inverse. So I will give you firstly a short definition of inverse of a matrix. That is, I have a square matrix A. A is a square matrix and its order is M. Okay, and another matrix B with the same order M. So A is one matrix A with order M, B is another matrix with order M. If possible to write A into B, product of two matrix is equal to B into A. First matrix into second matrix is equal to second matrix into first matrix, and the both result is equal to I. Then we can tell that this B is the inverse of the matrix A. If possible to write AB equal to I, BA equal to I, then we can tell that the matrix B is the inverse of A. How to write the or denoted inverse of a matrix? A inverse. This way we can write the inverse of a matrix. So, in this case, we can tell A is invertible. The matrix A is said to be invertible. How? I will show. For example, A is equal to 2, 3, 1, 2. A matrix. And B is equal to another matrix 2, minus 3, minus 1, 2. So we have two matrices. Let's find AB. Product of A into B. So 2, 3, 1, 2, 2 minus 3 minus 1. A into B. So first row into first column. So I will write here 2, 3, 1, 2. That is better. 2 minus 3 minus 1, 2. First row into first column. So 2 into 2 is 4. 3 into minus 1, minus 3. First row into second column. 2 into minus 3 is minus 6. 3 into 2 is 6. Second row into first column. 1 into 2 is 2. 2 into minus 1, minus 2. 1 into minus 3, minus 3. 2 into 2 is 4. We already discussed the product of matrix, right? It's equal to 4 minus 3, 1, 0, minus 6 plus 6 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0, minus 3 plus 4 is 1. So we got the matrix 1, 0, 0, 1. 1, 0, 0, 1 is an identity matrix. So we got AB equal to I. The same way we can find the BA. BA means this matrix into this matrix. So B is 2 minus 3 minus 1, 2. And in A is equal to 2, 3, 1, 2. Let's multiply first row into first column. 2 into 2 is 4 minus 3. First row into second column. 2 into 3 is 6. Minus 3 into 2 is minus 6. Second row into first column. Minus 1 into 2 is minus 2. 2 into 1 is plus 2. Minus 1 into 3, minus 3. 2 into 2 is 4. So, we will get 4 minus 3 is 1, 6 minus 6 is 0, minus 2 plus 2 is 0, minus 3 plus 4 is 1. Again, we got the identity matrix. So, we got AB equal to I, BA equal to I. AB equal to BA equal to I we got. So, we will tell B is the inverse of A. B is the inverse of A. So this matrix A is invertible. We can tell that the matrix A is invertible. Okay, this way we can tell that a matrix is invertible or not. But we are proceeding the questions by using the elementary operation. This is the concept behind the inverse of a matrix. That is, a matrix into another matrix will result to identity matrix, means that the one of the matrix is called the inverse of the other matrix. Here we can tell A is the inverse of B or B is the inverse of A because the both the product we got the identity matrix. Let's go how to find the elementary operations. So elementary operations means nothing but we are just interchanging by rows or columns, or just we are adding rows and columns by some basic properties. That is only the elementary operations, just adding or subtracting or scalar multiplication. Okay, the first one with example I will tell you. So I have a matrix A is equal to 2 3 1 3 2 6 and 4 5 3 is a 3 by 3 square matrix, right? So what is the row here? This is a row 1, row 2, row 3. That is 3 rows are here. So row 1 means row 1 I am denoting by R1. Row 2 is R2. Okay, column 1 2 3. So column C1 or C2 or C3, like this we are going to denote. Okay, so here elementary operations. Firstly, I am interchanging this rows. Row 1 to row 2. That is R1. This is the row 1. Changes to R2. So R1 changes to R2 means we are interchanging these two rows. Okay, is it possible? This is possible in this matrix. Okay, this is one of the elementary operations. That is, I am changing this R1 to R2. That is, now our R2 changes to R1. So 3, 2, 6, 2, 3, 1. Both the rows interchanged. Then the final row is same. This is one operation. The same we can applicable in the column case also. Okay, we can apply in this column case. So C1 changes to C2. Both interchange. We can possible to interchange C1 to C2 or C3 to C1, like that. Any way we can interchange these rows and column. This is the first elementary operation property. Hope you understood. Now our next property is multiplication by a non-zero number to any row or column is possible. So we have an example A is equal to 1, 2, 2, 3. Here Z1, Z2. This property is applying in this column base. Okay. Row is also possible. In this example I am showing with the column. So 1, 2 is the first column. So this first column changes to 1 by 2 C1. Okay. This C1, this column 1 is possible to change 1 by 2 into C1. That is 1 by 2 is a scalar. It's multiplying with the C1. So how we will write? 1 into 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. 2 into 1 by 2. 2 into 1 by 2. 2, 2 cancel. 1 will get. Then 2, 3 is the second column. This is the way. Okay. So this is the second property. First property is the interchange of any two rows or two columns is possible. The second one is multiplication by a non-zero number to any row or column is possible. Now the third one. For example, with example I will try. 1, 2, 2 minus 1 is 1 matrix. 1, 2, 2 minus 1. I am applying this R2. R2 is changing to R2 minus 2R1. This R2 is changing to R2 minus 2R1. That is, the addition to the elements of any row or column, the corresponding elements of any other row or column multiplied by any non-zero number is possible. So we can add these two rows. If R2 changes to R1 plus R2 is possible, or with any row or column we can multiply a scalar and then we can apply any operation. This is also possible. This is the next property. Okay, so here what we will do, R2 changes to R2 minus 2R1, but R1 no change. So we are writing 1, 2, Then R2 is, first one is 2. 2 minus 2 into R1. 2 minus 2 into 1 is, 2 minus 2 is 0. Minus 1. Minus 1 minus 2 into 2. So minus 1 minus 4 is minus 5. This is the matrix by applying this property. Hope you understood the third one. The addition to the elements of any row or column is possible by multiplying this scalar also. Then after multiplying the scalar also, we can add or subtract the rows or columns. This is the three properties. These three properties can apply both the rows and the columns. So total six properties are there, right? So okay, this is the basic elementary operations we need to apply in this inverse of a matrix. For finding the inverse, we should denote these two points. The matrices A and B, two matrices, should be square matrix. Then only we can find the inverse. Okay, so the given matrix should be square, then only we can find the inverse of the matrix. And the second one need to note this one is, if A, B is the inverse of A, then we can tell A is also the inverse of B. B is the inverse of A means A is the inverse of B. Both are same. Okay, now we can find one matrix inverse by applying the elementary operations. So A is equal to one matrix, 1, minus 1, 2, 3, a 2 by 2 matrix, a square matrix. So finding here only we got one matrix. So when for finding the inverse of a one matrix, firstly we will write A equal to I into A. What is I? I is an identity matrix. No, nothing will change by multiplying the identity matrix. So we can write 1, minus 1, 2, 3 is our A. And our I is 1, 0, 0, 1 by 2 by 2 matrix. So our identity matrix is this one. Into this A will keep like this only. Okay, so we wrote A equal to IA and we substituted everything. Now we need to apply our rows or column operations. Our aim is to find this left hand side should be identity. This is our aim to find. Then only we can find I is equal to A into A inverse model we will get. So this other matrix is called the inverse. This is the concept. Okay. So our aim is to find the identity matrix in this left side. How we will proceed? The first one, okay, 1. Now we need 1, 0, 0, 1. For that, firstly what we will do? This R2, we need to 0 here, right? So I am changing this R2. Here 2 is here. So 2 minus 2 you will get. Then we can write this is a 0. Right, identity matrix is the downside should be 0. So 2 minus 2. So 2 minus 2 means here minus 2 will come. So when you need this as a minus 2, just multiply this row 1 to 2. So how we will convert our transformation? R2, we need to change this R2, right? R2 changes to R2 minus 2R1. R2 changes to R2 minus 2R1. Then 2 minus 2 will get 0. Okay, so our R1 is same. So 1 minus 1. R2, 2 minus 2 is 0. 3, here will come 3 minus 2R1. 2 into minus 1. So 3 minus 2 into minus 1 is this changes to plus 2. So 3 plus 2 is 5. So our matrix changes to 1 minus 1, 0, 5 is equal to, here also we will apply the same thing. Okay, so the row 1 is same, R2, 0 minus 2 into R1, 0 minus 2 is minus 2, 1, this 0 is there, nothing will happen. So 1 will come here and A. Hope you understood this much, first transformation. Now, 1, 0, 0, 1. Here 1 we need. So we are changing this R2 changes to dividing by 5, that is multiplying by 1 by 5, it will changes to 1. So our next transformation is R2 changes to 1 by 5 R2 or R2 by 5. So what we will get? R1 is same, R2 0, 1 will come by dividing with 5. The same thing will apply in the right hand side also. So 1, 0, minus 2 by 5, 1 by 5 will come into A. Hope you understood this much. Again, our problem is here. We need to make this 1 minus 1 also 0. For that, what we will do? 1 and minus 1 are there. So by adding R1 and R2, it will changes to 0. So how we will write here? R1 changes to R1 plus R2. So R1, 1 plus 0, 1 itself. Minus 1 plus 1 is 0. R2 is same. Okay, now 1 plus minus 2 by 5. 1 plus minus 2 by 5. Then R1 plus R2. 0 plus 1 by 5 is 1 by 5. R2 same. 1 plus minus 2 by 5 means 5 plus minus 2 by 5. That is 3 by 5 will get here. 3 by 5 into A. So I is equal to 1 matrix into A. I is equal to A inverse into A, we can tell. So this matrix is called the inverse of A. 3 by 5. So A inverse is equal to 3 by 5, 1 by 5, minus 2 by 5, 1 by 5. This is called the inverse of A. Hope you understood the concept. So by finding this inverse, by applying the elementary operations. Hope you understood inverse of a matrix, how to find the inverse of a matrix. So this is my story today. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel for future videos.